Championship against Danial Williams.
I'll tell you, in DiBella's face-off look there, any bit of nervousness went away, and it changed the sheer intensity.
By the way, the action starts off extremely fast.
Fight!
DiBella being very aggressive with that heavy left-handed style. Likes to beat people up with the legs. Utilizing his range well, cutting the corners off. As Mini T tries to circle away from that power side. Nice straight left.
Nice leg kick there by the champion. Danny Williams has been in there against the likes of Ra Ting and Super Lick. Leg kick there. DiBella.
Love how DiBella hit that 2-3 combo and then slid back as Mini T was countering and evaded the entire combination. He does a good job not taking a lot of punishment on the inside.
It'll be interesting to see how
Williams
adjust to the speed advantage that DiBella is showing here. He's usually the faster fighter in there, but DiBella is touching him up in the first.
Another straight left for the Montreal Quebec native.
Williams is not exactly on steady legs right here yet.
Mini T switching to southpaw.
There's a right hook on the top of the head of Williams.
Going back and forth, his legs do seem unsteady, Rich.
You know, Jonathan DiBella made a comment this week talking about how Ra Tang couldn't finish Mini T, and it would be a statement and a big deal for him if he was able to finish Mini T. So I know that he's head hunting, leg hunting, and head hunting with that left leg of his.
Body shot by DiBella.
DiBella's doing a good job of working off that jab. Very educated jab he's got. Inside leg kicks moving Mini T around.
He's done a good job on the inside too, mixing up downstairs, upstairs. You see those hand combinations are really crisp. Comes back quick.
Right hook. For DiBella and another one. That rocked Williams. Fight. 30 seconds left this first round.
There's a speed difference, a clear speed difference here between DiBella and Mini T. So when Mini T lands these punches, he's got to make a count.
Right up to the body of Williams.
Big head kicks thrown by DiBella.
They begin the second round. DiBella looked very sharp in that first round, guys.
Mini T's listening to his corner, though, trying to eat up that lead leg of DiBella.
Go home, let's go!
What do you think of that corner advice from Mini T, Rich?
I like it. You know, DiBella's coming in heavy on that leg. And, you know, they're seeing that, so they're talking to go to the lead thigh and the low calf kick before he's throwing the hand combinations. And it's working. He's disrupted DiBella here now. He's landed two right hands in a row.
A straight left that puts down Williams momentarily, or wobbled him.
Didn't get a count though. I thought that may have been a knockdown.
Referee Justin Brown says no, they fight on. DiBella very heavy on that left leg kick too.
And this is why I'm not a referee.
We certainly have the best in the world here with one championship. We're watching the home of the world's greatest martial artist.
You know, if Mini T said it's the top of the hour, he said it as well. If he's going to turn this into a dogfight, he needs to really get in there and get DiBella active, because DiBella is fighting a style right now that's not utilizing a ton of energy. So he's going to still be fresh in rounds 4 and 5 if it goes that far.
Mini T likes that front kick up the middle. He's trying to dig those toes in the midsection of DiBella. Those seem to be his two primary weapons, is the leg kick and that front kick that he's looking for. He's got to be weary of those hands though, because he's kind of dropping his hands down, which is something the corner alluded to during the break. And he's throwing that kick.
Yeah,
his hands are coming down. See,
Mini T, he talked about this in the interview as well, about crossing over and doing MMA and how it's, you loosen up his technique, so to speak, because he's not focusing on his tight combination throwing his kicks. He leaves himself a little wide open after these shots.
DiBella trying to go up top with that big right hook, too. Narrowly misses. Sorry, Ray.
Oh, it's all good, bitch. The action is just so fast and furious that we can hardly keep up. And the fans here in the Pretty Boxing Stadium love what they're seeing. DiBella picking up the pace here.
Yeah, DiBella is throwing that 3-2 with some vicious intent with the leg kicks. And Miniti knows that weapon is coming. That's what he spoke to us in the interview about. He said, my weakness is my defense. And DiBella's weakness is his predictability. But it seems that Miniti hasn't really figured out the combination that DiBella's throwing at him.
Yeah, but I'll tell you, he landed three of those calf kicks unanswered. DiBella, you know it hurts when your opponent returns with one right there. That it was those calf kicks that allowed Miniti Williams to land that overhand right like he just did there.
They both exchange. Williams look around.
But DiBella's clearly controlling his rounds at this point.
What does Danial Williams need to do to try to swing the momentum back in his favor, guys?
I'll tell you, right there, those low kicks, they were effective at the open of the second round. They'll be effective at the open of this round. And he needs to keep doing that, but he has to set them up. He just can't swing wildly because as he's doing that, DiBella is beginning to read it. Miniti talked about DiBella's predictability. That's going to make him predictable and easy to counter.
Danielson's told us what it would mean for him to capture the one strawweight kickboxing world championship. He was born here in Thailand, now resides in Australia.
He's a very clean third round start for Jonathan DiBella. Clean shots landed, good head movement, avoiding a lot of damage coming back.
Look at that lead leg of DiBella. Miniti is chewing this thing up, and it does count for something.
Superficial damage. Let's see if he can go internal and start to create a little bit of stumbling from Miniti's.
I have to disagree with you. That's not superficial. It's cumulative, at least. And when you see bruising that deep, I might even argue there's some internal damage there.
It's a straight left by the champion.
Miniti listened to his corner, throwing a lot of leg kicks. Still touching DiBella, but DiBella doesn't really seem to be hindered by it. He's still being very aggressive in his shot selection and closing the distance. Nice body shot.
That's what Miniti can't afford to do, is miss those punches big and leave himself open for the return from DiBella. That was easy pickings. Beautiful combination there. Double jab from the inside and hit that combo to the body. DiBella's hands are so crisp. He always has them in a good position.
Under a minute left of this third round. DiBella in control here.
Undefeated as a boxer, both pro and amateur. DiBella's hands are looking good, but that leg kick, such a wise choice of investments for Miniti, hoping to pay dividends later into these championship rounds if it gets there.
DiBella, the champion, he has his own coffee brand. He's wide awake here as he's hammered away upon Danial Williams.
DiBella espresso, it is delicious though.
I must say, I enjoy it.
Danial Williams has got to put something on DiBella instead of just walking in the range like that. I do like these leg kicks though. Things.
Yeah, I'd like to see him throw maybe that 1-2 just to get DiBella to power up so that when he throws that leg kick, he's not eating punches by doing it. Now he's starting to put something in front of it, but he's eating a few shots on the aftermath.
Yeah, he's walking into range here. You know, you can't be in range without throwing something. You're entering a conversation without speaking, basically.
Do you think Danny Williams is feeling like a sense of urgency here as we start the fourth?
He should feel a sense of urgency. This is more than likely at a point where he's going to have to put Jonathan DiBella away in order to win this match. That depends on, you know, I'm not keeping a count on how many kicks he's actually landed. But when I watch his combinations from DiBella, even angling off and taking the stance out of Mini T or making Mini T move the way that he is. I can't see it.
Spinning a back fist for Cabela and a right hook to boot.
This is Mini T right here getting emotional. He needs to back out of that. He talked about that this week in the fight interview.
Danial Williams trying to get active, but he is getting hammered. He ate a right hook from the champion.
Beautiful counter shot by Cabela.
Yeah, Cabela took a good right hand on the chin from Mini T, but Mini T had to pay for it.
Williams trying to sit down on his shots, Ray.
Williams has gone to southpaw stance, trying to use another tactic to attack the champion.
Yeah, he's done this several times in this match. That's how Cabela's lead leg has gotten chewed up so terribly.
Does make good reads later in the fight. He's still got that knockout power with him in those championship rounds. So Mini T's got to stay very careful here. He starts dropping those hands, and that head kick might be coming right up top.
Yeah, we saw what Cabela did angling off against ZPM.
30 seconds left in the fourth round. Under 30 seconds remaining here in the fourth. Still, Danial Williams trying to put together more prolonged offense.
You know, Williams talked to us about being composed, being strategic, but does he need to throw caution to the wind at this point and just start to let it go?
Yeah, I believe so.
There's a leg
nice
kick
inside
there.
Leg kick taken out the leg. I believe so, Mitch. I believe that he's at that point where coming out into this final round, the fifth round.
Between Jonathan Cabela and Danial Williams.
I'm telling you, win or lose tonight, I'm looking at Cabela's leg, and I would not want to be the man laying in bed with that leg trying to sleep tonight.
Forget about sleeping. Talk about the 20-hour plane ride he's got to endure on the way back to Montreal.
That thing is going to throb like no other.
Danny wins with a body kick to start this fifth round. Goes back to southpaw.
But it'll hurt a lot less if he gets to take that 26-pound belt back home with him, though.
It'll probably hurt even less if you gave him a $50,000 bonus. Chacha gave him a $50,000 bonus.
But you got to finish, and Cabela can do it. But he's got to be very, very cerebral here in the fifth and final round, because he's hit Mini T with a lot of powerful shots, and Mini T is not backing down. Clean left hand landed by Cabela.
At this point, does Williams have to get creative and start to use unorthodox tactics?
He's trying, right? He's trying the flying knees, but he just can't quite connect because of the speed advantage that Cabela has. Cabela can kind of slow things down and really see the shots coming.
Mini T has the power in his hands to put Cabela down, but Cabela's so good with defense that he typically doesn't take the full brunt of Mini T's shots either.
What body work by Cabela.
Yeah, rip into the body is Jonathan Cabela looking for those body shots, just taking the wind out of you, but Mini T is absorbing things really, really well. Used to compete in those small gloves, Muay Thai and mixed martial arts. Nice leg kick there.
The undefeated champion from Montreal, so calm and composed, under a minute left here in the fight.
This would be a fun one to see run back in Muay Thai gloves.
That would be very, very interesting. I think Cabela's surely focused on kickboxing at the moment. You know, Mini T will fight anyone, anywhere, any sport.
Any weight.
Any weight. Cabela finding a groove here. 30 seconds to go in our strawweight kickboxing world title match here at Lumpini. Mini T continues to push forward, looking for a big shot.
Well, Jonathan DiBella did tell us he trained harder than ever before. You train at a different level when you're a world champion. He has displayed his brilliance here tonight against Danial Williams and a spinning back kick here at One Fight Night 15. What a performance by Jonathan DiBella.
Undisputed one strawweight kickboxing champion of the world, Jonathan.